olive and the fig plantation in Binyamina. These are the figs. You will see, hopefully, each one of them. We are under the pergola. You see two vines. They will have to cover the roof in a year time. And here are the figs. And here are the olives. The olives are 25 years old. And there are about 180 olive trees. The variety is Manzanillo. There's a lot of them in California. And I use them for olive oil and for olives to eat. I have two plots of figs. The older one, which is 4 years old, the older trees are 4, maybe 5 years, and the new one, the second one, with smaller fig trees. We'll see all of them in a while. We have another variety of olives, bigger ones, only to eat. It's the Novo variety, it's Italian variety. They will be much bigger in November when we'll pick them. It's a hot day. It's more than 30 degrees C. Let me calculate for you in Fahrenheit in a moment. This is about 96 degrees Fahrenheit. It's not the hottest day in Binyamina, but it's end of July, and but under the trees is quite pleasant. Believe me, if I take a chair here with a very light breeze, it's pleasant. This year I've built this small warehouse for fertilizers and tools and so on. These are trees made from cuttings. I prepare them to sell to the municipality. They plant them in the streets. These are the smallest trees planted end of last year. This is, believe it or not, this is half pound breba. They're almost half pound, even though they are summer figs, not brebas. I'll taste one of them, because these are the first that are ripe, or almost ripe now. Half pound breba. Lou Monticolo. And these are Uncle Mario. Let me test them. Really delicious. believe me, they are delicious. These are also a tree from Lou, Hardy Chicago. Some people, some friends are helping me to pick the figs. This is, for example, a Californian brown turkey, which we call in Israel Brazilian. Also, it is called Ojo de Valinus in Brazil, but it's Californian brown turkey. Lou can recognize them. This is Rouge de Bordeaux. It's an excellent fig. Rouge de Bordeaux. Californian brown turkey. This one is Castel Kennedy. It's a nice big fig. Looks nice also on the inside. Let's taste it. Something delicious. Very delicious. Do you know what is this? This is for caprification. This is a tree that needs caprification. Without caprification, all the fruits will fall down. In the small bucket, you put capri figs, male figs, with the blastophag inside, and they will caprify the female figs. Here is Dalmati. This is a very nice fig. I like it very much. Red inside, big one. She's very good. Today is Saturday, and we have invited some friends to join us in the afternoon and the evening to eat some figs and other stuff, getting together. It will go towards dark, so I prepared kerosene lamps because we don't have electricity here, and let's hope it will be enjoyable. It's called a Lux lamp, fed with kerosene. It has a very good light, almost a daylight. This is the second plot of the figs. Normally there are younger trees here. And this was a very bad land. And the drainage did not operate, it didn't function here. And all the trees, the old trees, the olive trees here were dead. And all the area was like a big lake in the winter. And the water didn't drain out. So I fixed the drainage. And now it's okay. And I planted mainly figs, but not only figs. And recently, I've planted date trees. Here you can see very young date trees that we tear them that way during the hot summer until they will acclimatize themselves and will remove all these clothing after the heat, let's say in September. And also some citrus trees. Here you see small trees, another one, a big lemon tree, a big, relatively big mango. There near the fence is avocado tree. And here are the newest fig trees. Every one a different variety. We'll go over it in this movie. We'll look at them one by one. This variety is Rond de Bordeaux, one of the best varieties, even though they are small figs, but the taste is excellent. I consider it to be one of the best figs ever, Rond de Bordeaux. I think the origin is Provence, France. This is a fig I planted last year and already brings some excellent fruits. It's called Jaffa. The tree is called Jaffa, which means comes from Jaffa, the city of Jaffa, near Tel Aviv. This is a different variety. Also a French variety. I will remember the name in a moment. Rond de Bordeaux. Believe me, I tasted it. It's excellent. This is the Jerusalem fig. It's a big fig. Very good. I don't know why they call that Jerusalem. It's a French fig. Here is the participation of the birds. They like the fig enormously. Enormously. Blue, and this is the chickadee fig. That's the cutting I took from you. You recognize them, isn't it? honey. My daughter Daphna. This is my daughter Daphna.
Who are you telling it to?
Ruby, her husband.
Hello.
And the children. This is Shir.
Shira.
Hadar.
Hadar.
Abigail. I don't know.
Hadar.
Abigail.
And Ayala, she's there. Where is Ariel?
He's sleeping.
Sleeping in the car. They come to one of those meetings. This is Ariel, my youngest grandson.
He's still sleeping.
Absolutely. Ariel, he's sleeping. And this is my youngest daughter, Ruti, with her two daughters. And here is Ayala, my second granddaughter, in a series of nine. And this is Daphna and Ariel. Now the children have gone to the plantation. Here is Adar. They said this is Siamese twins. Nahon? Figs. Can you open it? At your wife talk at the
שנאכל
אותם. Open it completely, תפתחי את זה לגמרי, שנראה את הצבע מבפנים.
אני לא אכלה.
אז אחד תשימי בצד ותבצעי אותו, את השני.
אני יכולה, אבל אני פשוט...
את רוצה כיסא נוח?
לא.
נראה? אה, ביוטיפול. תתאמי את זה. Is it good? מה את אומרת? זה טוב? אה?
לא, כן, אבל בגלל שבת, בדיוק, אז הם נשארו שישי שבת באוזונגול, ושם פגשתי אותם. אז אנחנו עושים את הארוחת הערב באוזונגול.
ביי לכולם.
Many people came to eat figs. Many of our friends, they like to come here and celebrate in the evening. They come in the afternoon where there is enough light to pick the figs and stay in the evening when it's cooler so we can sit and drink beer or hard liquor, eat figs, or lychee, for example. Everybody brings something. This is lychee, is a kind of exotic fruit. It is grown in the Galilee, and somebody brought it, and it's a very good fruit. Picking figs with the aid of Thailandese people. Let's see if I could sell these on the market. Here is how I make the fig brandy. That's a gas, and in the outer vessel you have the thermal oil heating the distillator. Here you see a thermometer, and the vapor outlet goes to a condenser, and here is the bottle that will collect drops of brandy. Now it's only the beginning of the operation. The temperature is around 40 degrees C of the vapors. It's time to go until the distillation will start. In general, this is the basement of my house. Here are fermentation barrels. Each one you ferment the figs with yeast, normally yeast for grapes or wine, and here is all the documentation needed. Here I write the results of the test, because I can't call it industry. It's only experiments now. After that, we'll have a bigger pilot plant, and then we'll contact some winery that will subcontract the fig brandy. Now the distillation is in full gas ahead. One bottle already completed, the second one is distilled very quickly. It's pouring into the bottle. 50%, 60% alcohol. After that, we'll have to dilute it. Let me explain what we see here. This is the small black tank is the oil container. The oil is heated by the gas flame. Here you see two thermometers measuring the temperature of the oil. It's about 120 degrees Celsius. Inside is the distiller with his own thermometer, vapor thermometer, and this is done in order not to overheat the bottom of the distiller, not to burn the fermented stuff, which contains also some solids remaining of the fig paste. The temperature now is 50.5 degrees C. The distillation didn't start yet. And the temperature of the oil is 120 degrees C, 0.9. the fig brandy is pouring into the bucket.
Bye bye, my dear. I will miss you very much.